Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing tangent and velocity problems. Our example is the following. A ball is thrown into the air. Its height in feet after t seconds is given by this position function, which is s of t equals 60t minus 16t squared. In part A, we're being asked to find the average velocity over three intervals, 1, 1.1, 1, 1.01, and then 1, 1.001. You see that the interval gets smaller and smaller. In part B, we have to estimate the instantaneous velocity at t equals 1. So the idea here is that as the interval gets smaller, our average velocity will get closer to the instantaneous velocity. So based on part A, we should be able to guess and get an answer for part B. Let's go ahead and carefully work through this. So the formula for the average velocity over an interval, so over AB, is the following. It's S of B minus S of A, all divided by B minus A. This is the formula for the average velocity. So it's the change in position over the time elapsed, because in the numerator you have, you know, the position function evaluated at B minus the position function evaluated at A. And in the denominator you have basically the time elapsed, which is B minus A. Let's go ahead and do each one of these very carefully. Let's start with 1, 1.1. So over bracket 1, 1.1. We're going to have S of 1.1 minus S of 1. All of this is being divided by 1.1 minus 1. Notice the numbers match, so it's pretty easy to memorize the formula. You see you have a 1.1 here inside your function S, and then there's a 1.1 right below it. Likewise here, there's a 1 inside your function, and there's a 1 right below it. So S of 1.1 basically is the function S of t evaluated at 1.1. So everywhere we see a t, we're going to put a 1.1. So it's going to be 60 times 1.1 minus 16 times 1.1 squared. And then minus, and then S of 1. Now, because S of t is two terms, we do need parentheses here. It'll be 60. Then we plug in 1 for the t, so times 1 minus 16 times 1 squared. Beautiful. All of this entire thing is divided by 1.1 minus 1, which is simply 0.1. By the way, this piece here, 60 minus 16 times 1 squared, this is really 60 minus 16, which is 44. Okay, and I mentioned that because you're following along, it's going to make it easier for the future computations. So once you put this in your calculator, you should get 26.4. And the units here are feet per second. So feet per second. This would be the first answer. This would be the average velocity over the interval 1, 1.1. The reason it's feet per second is because the position function is in feet, and the units for t are seconds. The time is in seconds. All right, let's go ahead and do it over another interval. So over the next interval, which is 1, 1.01. The same thing, except now it's S of 1.01 minus S of 1 over, and then it's 1.01 minus 1. So this is, so S of 1.01 basically means that you plug in 1.01 for all your t's in your function S of t, which is up here. It's 60t minus 16t squared. So we're just going to put a 1.1 there, 1.01 for all the t's. So it's 60 times 1.01 minus 16 times 1.01 squared minus 44. You see why I did that? Because it makes the computation easier, right? Because the second term is S of 1, but we already did that, and it's 44. So it just saves us a lot of time. On the bottom here, we have 0.01. So this is equal to 27.84 feet per second. That would be the average velocity over the interval 1, 1.01. And the last one we have to do is over the interval 1, 1.001. So over the interval 1, 1.001, we have S of 1.001. These problems with numbers always take a little bit longer. You just got to be careful. Over 1.001 minus 1. So as before, we plug in the 1.001 for the T. So 1.001 minus 16 times 1.001 squared. Minus 44. Over, all of this is over 0.001. And if you put this in your calculator, you should get 27.984 feet per second. That would be the average velocity over the interval 1, 1.001. So now we can do part B, which is pretty obvious. So for part B, oh, and this was part A. This is the solution to A. So for part B, it's pretty clear that the average velocity is approaching 28. That should be the instantaneous velocity at t equals 1. 28 feet per second is our answer for part B. So the closer, the smaller the interval gets, the closer the approximation is, right, to the actual velocity at that instant in time when t is equal to 1. Hence the name instantaneous, right? It's the velocity at that actual, you know, instant in time, which is kind of cool. Hopefully this video has been helpful. And by the way, for tangent lines, it's exactly the same, right? Instead of average velocity, you've got the slope of the secant line, which approaches the slope of the tangent line. So same thing. Hopefully this video has been helpful and you've learned some math. Average velocity is a little bit tricky because the formula itself is something that people always forget. Just remember, you have to use your position function for average velocity. Later on, when you actually learn more calculus, you'll discover that you have the velocity function, so people tend to forget this formula. Remember, average velocity uses the position function. Anyways, I hope this video has been helpful. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.